I chose to check my home for radon because when we were working on the radon project through the Washington Tracking Network, I saw that in my area through the geology risk map, there was a high risk for radon in my area. And when we were looking at the testing, there had never been any testing in my zip code. I wanted to check it to see because I have a basement and I have a child that's living in one of the rooms down in the basement, as well as other children in the home. And us living here for a long time, I wanted to know if there was radon in the home.
Radon is a naturally occurring radioactive gas. It is odorless, tasteless, and invisible. So the only way to determine if you're being exposed to it is to test for it. Radon is considered a significant source of lung cancer for people who are non-smokers. And if you are a smoker and you're exposed to radon, it significantly increases your risk of getting lung cancer. The Washington Tracking Network has shown us that the problem is more broadly distributed than we previously thought.
We know from working with our radiation program historically that radon in Washington can be a problem. The Washington Tracking Network got involved with the radon program and developing these radon maps and tables, charts, to improve access to these data, making them available to the public, in hopes that these data, by making them available, people would use this information and make local decisions for testing in their homes, finding out whether they're exposed or not exposed, and to help improve their health.
Washington Tracking Network has previously only shown maps at the county level. This gives people a very broad view of what is happening in the state of Washington. With the development of this topic, we were able to bring the data down to a finer scale, zip code level. And so now people can see in their neighborhood what the differences are between their area and surrounding areas.
Because of the Washington Tracking Network, we are able to put data together that we've never been able to before. We haven't had the ability to provide the data to communities, to stakeholders, to local health jurisdictions in a way that they could effectively use it before now.
I would tell people that live in Washington about the radon maps that they need to look to see what area they live in. They need to see if they have a high, moderate, or low risk for radon. And especially if they live in a high risk area, they need to test their homes.
Without the tracking network, we would be struggling very much right now to address the emerging issues. We would be struggling to link environmental exposure information with health outcome information. And more importantly, we'd still be struggling trying to make the connection with some of our programs. Tracking has really laid a strong foundation and fostered those relationships to the benefit of us all.